Indiana. The pastor is Bishop Thomas H. Willis Jr. and our overseer is Apostle Paul Grant. Let us pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you for this another day. We thank you for another opportunity, O God, to give you the glory, honor, and praise that's due unto you. We ask that you bless in this service on today. Move by your power and your spirit, O God. Open up the hearts and minds of the people that are listening, O God. Give them an ear to hear what your word has to say, God. In the name of Jesus, God, we pray that you would save souls everywhere, O God. Baptize with your precious Holy Ghost, God. Draw people in as only you can, God. In the name of Jesus, have your way in the service, oh God. Let your word have free course, oh God. In the name of Jesus, oh God, touch everyone, oh God, in your bodies, oh God. In the name of Jesus, God, even with this coronavirus going on, we know, oh God, that you're able to protect us, oh God, to build a fence around us, oh God. Lord, and to bless those that have it already, oh God, you're able to heal, deliver, and set free according to your will, God, in the name of Jesus. And we'll give you all the glory, honor, and praise that's due unto you. In Jesus' name we pray. Jesus' name. Yes. Thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
Amen. Amen. I will read for your hearing Isaiah, the first chapter, and I will read the 15th through the 20th verse. Amen. It says, and when you spread forth your hands, I will hide mine eyes from you. Yea, when you make many prayers, I will not hear. Your hands are full of blood. Wash ye, make you clean. Put away the evil of your doings from before mine eyes. Cease to do evil. Learn to do well. Seek judgment, relieve the oppressed, judge the fatherless, plead for the widow. Come now, let us reason together, said the Lord. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be as white as snow. Though they be red like crimson, they shall be as wool. If you be willing and obedient, ye shall eat the good of the land. But if ye refuse and rebel, ye shall be devoured with the sword. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken it. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading, hearing, and obeying of his holy word.
Amen.
Amen. And now, without further ado, we'll bring our pastor, amen, Bishop Thomas H. Willis Jr. I pray that you would listen attentively, amen, and hide this word in your heart that you might live for Christ and not sin against him. Amen. God bless you, Bishop Willis.
Yes, yes, yes. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing there will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. One more time. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing there will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory.
Well done, thou good and faithful servant.
That's what God is looking for, faithful. a year. But he's looking for somebody that's going to be faithful to him every day. 365 days a year. Amen. Serving God in the beauty of holiness. Amen. Thank God for his word. Amen. And I don't mean play with this thing. Yeah, I mean, if I'm going to be holy, I'm going to be holy.
That's right.
If I'm going to be in the world, I'm going to be in the world. Because no man can serve two masters. You're either going to hate one or love the other.
Right now.
Amen. Thanks be to God that gives us the victory, even our faith. We have overcome the world.
Yes.
And that's my testimony. I have overcome the sinful things of the world.
Amen.
And you can do it too.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. There's no such thing, well, you know, maybe you can do it, but I can't.
Okay.
Amen. That's because you don't have faith in God. And you just don't believe that you can do it. But I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. The reason why I'm living the way I'm living is because of God. Because of Christ.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, sometimes we're tempted with temptation. Sometimes the devil trying to draw us out. Amen. But me don't give up Jesus. Amen. Amen. I got to serve him every day.
Because
we don't know when our time is going to come when we're going to leave here.
That's right.
Look what's going on now. The coronavirus.
Yes.
Amen. It's killing folks. Amen.
Yes.
Amen. But see, look, let me just tell you something. When you are living right and walking right, other people gonna die. You ain't got to be nervous.
That's right.
You ain't got to fear. Amen. Because if you leave here, you're going to be, amen, forever before the Lord.
Amen.
Am I right about it?
Yes.
That is what we are looking for.
Amen.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
We know that death is the enemy, but when we die in God, Scripture said, precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints.
Amen.
Saints. Not those that ain't, but saints.
Amen.
It's precious before God. We are a precious jewel.
Amen.
I just love him. I love him. I just love him. How about you?
Oh, yes.
Amen. And I get excited, amen, when it comes down to talking about Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Amen. And that's my testimony, amen, that I have overcome the world.
Amen.
Amen. If Christ was to come right now, I'm ready to go.
All right now.
Amen. Amen. I ain't got the time to say, wait, you know, wait on my children. Wait a minute, Lord. I gotta go get my children. Wait a minute, I gotta go get my cousin. Wait a minute, I gotta go get my uncle. You gotta save yourself.
Amen.
In this untoward generation.
Yeah.
You hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
Look, you know, it's amazing how people start calling on God, amen, when they get in trouble water.
Yes.
When they get in the coronavirus, now everybody wanna pray. Everybody want mercy. Everybody want God to come, amen, and in their favor. Amen, but God wants you too.
Amen.
God is calling you too. Ain't nothing wrong with going to God, but God is calling you too.
Amen.
Because what happens when the fear go away?
Now, right now.
Some people go right back to their pernicious ways. They go back to their sin.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
They stop going to church.
Yes.
Amen. They stop praying and getting on their knees.
Come on.
But if you really serious, amen, about God, amen, sparing your life,
yes,
and you want to serve him when the coronavirus, amen, succeed, dissipate, you'll still live that life.
All right now.
Because you want to be saved,
amen,
and you want to be sanctified.
Amen.
Do y'all hear what I'm saying?
Come on.
Because there is a life after death.
Yes, there is.
There is a life after death.
Yes, there is.
There is a life after death. The point is once for man to die, after that the judgment. You have to stand before God.
Yes.
That's why I'm living the life every day.
Amen, amen.
But while I'm living this life, I'm examining myself.
Yes.
And how do you examine yourself? Through the word.
Through the word.
By God's word.
Amen.
You can't examine yourself by your own flesh.
No, no, no.
Because the flesh will tell you, you all right, man.
All right,
you know you all right. God know we can't help you
stand.
You know, you do what you do. You know,
that's
you still
right.
Go to church. God understand.
Amen.
Yeah, God understand that you're going to hell.
Yes.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
If you don't live right.
Come on.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
But thanks be to God to give us our victory, even in our faith.
Amen.
We have overcome the world.
Amen.
Amen. We have overcome the wicked one, which is Satan.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Because he's going about as a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour.
Amen.
And he's devouring people. He's turning folks.
Now.
I mean, people are leaving.
Yes.
They're leaving here, folks. And they're looking at the quantity and the amount of people that are leaving here. And they still, you see how much on God they are. They taking tests and doing all this, which is okay. But still, it's good to have a peace of mind, knowing. Because see, just because we're sanctified don't mean that it's not going to affect us.
All right, all
Because we're living in this world.
Yes.
So some of these diseases and some of these sicknesses and stuff like that, we're going to die from too.
All right.
But the thing about it is are you ready?
Amen.
Are you ready? Ask yourself this question. If I should die now, am I ready?
Come on now.
To stand before God. Where is my soul going when I'm in here? Because everybody's not going to heaven. I keep telling you that. Everybody's not going to heaven. Only but the pure in heart shall see God.
Amen.
Do you hear what I'm saying? But I got a little something for you today. Amen. I'm excited about God. God gave me a little something. I was woke up out of my sleep. And I thought about the word examine.
Amen.
I thought about the word examine. And the definition of examine is to inspect something in detail. In detail. So when you're trying to inspect something in detail, you ain't going to be in a hurry to do it. You want to make sure that you're going to read it out. You understand what I'm saying? You're going to look at it.
Come on.
And look it over distinctively so you can understand what's going on. To inspect something in detail is to determine the nature or condition of something. And I got a question to ask you. When was the last time you examined yourself?
All right.
When was the last time you let God examine you? When was the last time that you examined yourself through the Word of God? When was the last time when you were sitting in the church and God was preaching the Word of God and the things that He was saying, and you were examining yourself to see, amen, whether you fit that category when it came down to sin, or whether you fit that category when it came down to righteousness? Do you hear what I'm saying? We can't take it for granted that we all right with God when we ain't all right with God. I'm just going to tell you like this. Because I always say, just because you go to church don't mean you sanctified.
That's right.
Amen. There's a lot of sinners in the church, and the churches are full. Right now, they're kind of empty because of the coronavirus. Amen. But this is just a church building, but we are the church.
Amen.
We are the temple of God. We are the temple of God. And the temple of God dwells in us.
Yes.
But when was the last time you examined yourself? When was the last time you got on your knees and you searched yourself and prayed to God, God, if you find anything in me that shouldn't be, take it out and strengthen me. And I mean, be serious about it. God, I want to know, amen, am I walking right? Am I talking right? Am I doing right? Am I living right? Am I seeing right? Am I talking right? Examine yourself. Because see, so many people are walking around trying to examine other people.
Yeah.
Looking at other people, finding faults in other people. Amen. But what about yourself?
Amen.
You looking past yourself. When was the last time you looked in the mirror? Some of us look in the mirror every day.
Right.
Every day some of us stand up in the mirror. Sometimes people stand up there in the mirror 15 minutes examining themselves, trying to fix themselves up, combing their hair. Amen. When they see something out of play, they try to put it in out of play. But what about God? How many times have you given God the time to search yourself? So you can be holy. When was the last time?
Come on.
Because the only way you can examine yourself is through the Word of God.
Amen.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
How many of us, if we were to be afflicted with the coronavirus or anything that causes death, would be ready to meet their Maker in peace?
Come on now.
Now, if you got a question mark in there, you need to examine yourself.
All right.
I don't know. I think I'm all right with God. You know what?
No,
you got to know
it. Amen.
You got to know that you know that you're all right with God. And this, like I said, about looking in the mirror every day when you go into your bathroom or when you go in there and you stand before your dresser, there's a mirror, right? There's a reflection of you, right? So when you're looking at you, like I said, you see something out of place, you straighten it out. If your tie's crooked, you straighten it up.
All right.
Amen? Because you don't want to go out there looking crazy, looking silly, or whatever the case may be. Amen. But see, the same way, God, this is your mirror.
All right.
The Bible, the Word of God is your mirror. How many times do you go in the Bible to see yourself and see whether you're in place with God? Oh, my God. Am I in place with God? And God will show you yourself. It's amazing how sometimes when God shows people themselves, they turn the pages.
Yes, yes.
They go to that place where the Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. But when they start telling you to put away fornication, and when they start telling you, amen, stop lying, And it takes 365 days a year. And on the leap year, they got, what, 366, 24 hours a day to mind your own business and examine yourself. Before you start pointing at somebody, they going to hell. Where are you going?
Come on, man.
When was the last time you examined yourself?
Come on.
We should always examine ourselves. Always. Like I said, by the word. We ought to examine even the things that we say or do. We ought to examine ourselves and say, well, did I say that right?
Come on.
Did I say that, amen, the way it should have been said? Did I use choice words, or did I curse somebody out? Or did I do something or say something sharply that I shouldn't say it? Do you hear what I'm saying?
Come on now.
Or what you do, did you do the right thing today? Did you do the right thing yesterday? Did you do the right thing when you got up? Amen. Some of y'all, when you get up in the morning, you're so mean as Joe Green. Amen. You're ready to fight. You're ready to argue. Is that the kind of attitude that God wants you to have as a child of God?
No.
They better not mess with me today. They better not mess with me tonight. You need to examine yourself.
Yes.
And see, because God, people got love.
Yes.
And when you got the love of God in you, you are sweet. That don't mean that you won't get angry sometimes. But God know how to, amen, to subside that,
yes,
anger. Let you know, come on now, calm down, calm down.
Mm-hmm.
When you get to the place where you so hot you almost about to curse, you can examine yourself.
Amen.
Amen. Oh,
amen.
You know what, girl? You almost made me curse you out.
Oh,
no, that ain't a child of God.
No.
That ain't a son and a daughter of God. Are y'all control with me now? When was the last time?
Glory to
some
God.
People don't want to go in that mirror. They don't want to go see that mirror because you know you're going to find something you don't want to find. You got to give it up.
Exactly.
You got to take it off.
Yes.
Walking around with a false face. Do you hear what I'm saying? And I'm not just talking about makeup and stuff. I'm talking about a false face. Amen. You smiling and whatnot and acting like you say mistakes. You know, you're giving a false facade,
right,
about who you are. But behind that, amen, the Bible says you are like dead men bones. Amen. You living a double life. God don't have people living a double life. And like I said, only time people sometimes get scared, they get so scared, they get so nervous. Amen. At a point like this, until like they start running to church. I remember that happened before. People were running to church, coming to church. They were faithful in church. Whatever the preacher said, they sung the song, they got in church. And soon as it was all over, they stopped coming to church.
Amen.
That goes to show you where their heart is.
Right.
Their heart is not really in serving God.
Come on.
Their heart is only in getting out of trouble, keeping God from killing, keeping the disease from killing you.
Right.
But do you hear what I'm saying? I understand what you're doing, but still, you ought to be thankful for God, to God, that God caused this thing to, amen, come over you and not touch you. Ride over you and don't touch you. And don't touch your family.
Yes.
Are you thanking God for it?
Come on now.
Are you giving God the glory? Are you giving God? Amen. Thank you for sparing my life, God. That could have been me. That could have been me in the grave. That could have been me. Amen. Sick like that. Amen.
Yes.
But you made death behave. That could have been me. Amen. That's the kind of thing you need to talk to God about. That,
yes.
And showing God what? That you're grateful. I'm grateful.
Yes.
Every day when I get up, I say, God, I'm grateful. I am so grateful to you because I am what I am by the grace of God.
Yes.
If it wasn't for you, where would I be? Some of us know we should have been in the grave. But God made death behave. But to the saints of God, when you know that you are ready,
yes,
and your life measures up to holiness,
yes,
you ain't got to be exist. You ain't got to be afraid that this thing is going to hit you because it may hit you. Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death
thank
of his
Lord.
Saints.
Glory to God.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
Precious. You're precious.
Yes, yes.
You're more precious than silver and gold.
Amen.
Come on now.
Amen.
You're precious to God.
Come on. Amen.
And then when you come before God, you're glorifying God.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. You're in paradise.
Yes.
That's what I'm looking for. How many of us, if Christ was to come right now, will we be ready to be called up to meet the Savior in the air? No, I don't want to come right now.
Come on, come on, man.
Because see, I need to get myself together. I need to get rid of my boyfriend.
Right.
Now is the time.
Now is the time.
Now is the day.
Yes, it is.
Today, if you hear his voice, harden not your heart.
Come on now.
What's wrong with doing it now? What you putting God off for?
Right. Amen.
What you putting it off for?
Come on.
You know, God get tired of people putting him off, and then when they putting them, you know, they like back and forth. They want God, and then when they get into you know, a place where they feel like everything is okay, then they don't want God.
Right. Amen.
I still say you can't serve two masters.
No, you can't.
And then I can say too, you're a hypocrite.
That's right. That's right.
You're a hypocrite.
Amen.
Pretending to be something, pretending you want God so you can get out of trouble.
Right.
No, no, no. Don't use God like that. Let me just read this. 2 Corinthians 13 and 5. 2 Corinthians 13 and 5. What did that say, Evangelist? 2 Corinthians 13 and 5.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
God is so good.
Examine yourself.
Examine. This is in the Bible. We're supposed to do this. Even as saints, we're supposed to examine ourselves. I don't care if you've been saved for 30 years. Amen. You still want to examine yourself.
Amen.
And see whether you're still on the right road.
Yes.
Whether you're still pleasing God. What's wrong with asking God, God, am I pleasing you? I gave that example again. I'm going to give that definition again about examine. It's to inspect something in detail to determine the nature or condition of something. To investigate thoroughly.
Amen.
That means you got to look yourself over. All over. Do you hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
You got to make sure your feet is doing right.
Uh-huh.
And what I mean by that is going to the right place.
Yes. Yes.
Oh, y'all better come on now. Amen. Your feet should be taking you, amen, to the horse, to the race course. What is that?
Racetrack.
Racetrack.
Amen.
To the gambling joints.
Come on.
Come on now. Your feet ought to be ready to go into the house of the Lord. Yes. To serve God. But thoroughly, look at yourself all over. Because some people don't want, like I said, they don't want to see themselves. Let me see. Going back to the explanation.
Amen.
The definition. To investigate thoroughly, which means rigorously in depth, from top to bottom. From top. You look at yourself all over.
Amen.
Because sometimes when you go into that bathroom, you can only see half of yourself.
Okay.
Depending on how large, because some people have that whole mirror where you can see your whole self.
Come on.
And then you can just turn around sideways, look in the back, turn around this way, you look it in the back. But if you just got that one mirror, you can only just see sometimes from the waist up.
Amen.
But you're not seeing how it is down there. How many of y'all walked out and sometimes said, I looked in the mirror, but you know what? I didn't even think about looking down.
Come on.
And see how I was. I didn't even see that I had on the wrong pair of shoes.
It happens.
You didn't put on the wrong pair of shoes. See, you didn't examine yourself and make sure you was all right. Come on now. Y'all know sometimes you walk out here, you thought you had certain things, and you thought you had the right pair of pants on, and you didn't. Because you didn't examine yourself. Same way with God. You think you're all right with God, but you're not.
Come on.
God's telling you you're not. Some of you all, God know that you're not.
All right.
And you got to know and recognize that you're not.
Say that.
And how you going to do that is beholding that mirror, looking in the mirror in the Word of God.
Amen.
Again, rigorously in depth, from top to bottom, to scrutinize. Also means the same thing, to examine or inspect closely and thoroughly. And I put this on here, by the Word of God.
Amen.
This Word will not fail you. This Word will tell you about yourself if you want to know about yourself.
Come on.
It'll let you know whether you're on the right road or whether you're on the wrong road. Whether you're living for God or whether you're not living for God. See, in the Bible, it doesn't say nothing about it's okay for you to straddle the fence.
No, it doesn't. No, it doesn't.
You're either going to be holy or you're not going to be holy.
Amen.
You're either going to be sanctified or you're not going to be sanctified.
Come on now.
Come on now. I mean, you just got to be real when it comes down. Examine yourself. You know, you need to make up in your mind right now. I'm going to start examining myself. And how do I do it? Ooh. And I say it again. You can't be examining yourself by your own mind.
That's right.
Because by your own mind, you think you look okay.
Amen.
You think you're doing okay. But when you talk to God, God will talk to your mind and let you know you need to come up in this. You need to come up in that. You need to get rid of this. You need to get rid of folks. You need to get folks out of your life because they're changing you. They're causing you and they're tempting you, and you letting them tempt you, and you're going there.
Come on now.
You need to stand for me.
Amen.
This is what God has said. You need to stand for me. Stop worrying about what folks are doing and what folks saying. Examine yourself. Who do you love, God?
Come on.
Or the people, or your family, or your friends, or the world.
Come on.
Examine yourself. Hey. Sometimes you have to examine yourself. Sometimes I have to examine myself. Man, what did I eat today? I rehearse it over in my mind. Because I'm not feeling too good. Uh-huh. Then I go, oh, man. Because I start rehearsing. I said, I ate this, I ate that, I ate this. Oh, okay. I ate this and I shouldn't have ate this. See, that's the way you got to be with God. God, I'm doing this, I'm doing that, I'm doing that, I'm doing this. God, the Holy Ghost say, well, you ain't doing this. Oh, yeah. See, people like that, well, sometimes people will say, Lucia.
All right.
Lucia, that ain't nothing but the devil. No, that's God trying to tell you about yourself and what you should get rid of.
Come on.
I'm tired of folks telling me, you know, we going to hell. Yeah, that's where you're going if you're not living right.
What we only doing is
doing what God told us to do.
Right.
And it's to reach out to folks, to the souls, and let them know, amen, it's all in this or hell.
Amen.
Amen. They got a movie out, all dogs are going to heaven. But dogs ain't going to heaven. People live like animals and stuff like that, but they're not going to heaven.
Come on.
Scrutinize. Examine. God, if you find anything that shouldn't be, that's all right to say, take it out and strengthen me.
Yes, yes.
I want to be right. I want to be saved. I want to be made whole. I think it goes like, search me, Lord. Search me, Lord. Search me, Lord. Search me, Lord. Let a light from heaven fill my soul. If you find anything that shouldn't be, take it out, Lord, and strengthen me. Cause I want to be right, I want to be saved, I want to be whole. Oh, search me, Lord. Do you sing that song? And don't just sing it, but mean it.
Come on now.
Mean it.
Amen.
And you know what? We ought to get to a place that even if the coronavirus or any kind of disease affect us, you ought to be like Paul. In 2 Timothy 4, 6 through 8, this is what Paul was talking to Timothy.
Amen.
This was so important to do, like Paul said.
Amen.
In 2 Timothy 4, 6 through 8, what did that say?
For I am now ready to be offered, and the time of my departure is at hand.
See, when you know that you're walking right, you examine yourself, and you're living right daily, and you're praying before God, and you're seeking God, and if there's anything that you can find or anything that you can see that God can show you, you take it off and you walk in your right before God. When you get to this place, you ain't got to fear death. If you understand what I'm saying.
Come on.
I'm not saying that we shouldn't not want to die.
Come on.
But death to the point where you just so fearful until you just can't, you know, you just can't sleep.
Come on now.
But when it comes down to this, I keep telling you, the Bible said, precious is the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. But look what Paul said, for I am now ready. You can get to that place where I am now ready to be offered. God, I done did what I'm supposed to do. I done kept your commandments. I done made up right. Now, God, at this point, can you say that?
Come on now.
No, I ain't ready to go yet because I still want to do. You still want to do what? You want to do what? I still want to be with my family. There's nothing wrong with that. But still, that's not going to stop God from allowing you to leave here.
Right.
That still doesn't want to stop death from coming taking you away. Because death does not have what? Respect the person.
Amen.
He ain't going to say, oh, my bad. I ain't supposed to take you. Do you hear what I'm saying?
Come on.
When it comes to take.
Yes, it does.
Death comes to take away.
Amen.
For I am now ready to be offered, and the time of my departure is at hand. He knew he was getting close. I have fought. See, is that your testimony? I have fought. See, he examined himself, and he expressed it to Timothy. I have fought a good fight. Uh-huh.
I have fought a good fight.
Uh-huh.
I have kept the faith.
Uh-huh.
I have finished my course.
I have finished my course.
I have kept the faith.
I have kept. See, this is the testimony that you got to have Amen. When you're faced with death, when you're faced with tribulations and troubles, God, I'm ready. Whatever, I'm ready. If you want to take me, I'm ready. But God can fix you for that. God can fix you for that. I have had people that were saying that I'm ready to go. I have been to people's beds and they say, I'm ready, child, and had a smile on their face.
Yes.
Man, that's something. God can fix you for that.
Yes, he can.
The 8th verse.
Henceforth, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day, and not to me only, but unto all them also that love his appearing.
This is what he recognized. If I leave here, henceforth there is laid up for me a crown. Oh my God. A crown of righteousness. He will crown us.
Glory to
with
God.
With righteousness.
Yes.
With royalty. With peace.
Come on.
And joy. With the Lord. What is that?
Which the Lord, the righteous judge.
He is the righteous judge. When he will judge in righteousness.
Shall give me at that day.
At that day, at that time that I die or stand before God. Amen. He will judge me righteously.
And not to me only.
Not just to me. God ain't got no respect to person. But to all them that also love his appearing. Want to see him come. Love is appearing. Come on, Lord. Do you want to see him? No, I got to get a few things together first. I got to get a few things together. I don't blame you if you ain't living right. Amen. I wouldn't want to leave you here either. If you're not living right, it's amazing. I would be scared to leave here knowing that I can measure up to what God wants me to be measured up to when it comes down to seeing Christ and seeing God. Amen.
Amen.
All right. Let's go to something else. Let's go to 2 Corinthians 13 and 5.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
2 Corinthians
13 and 5.
Amen.
I kind of read some of it. 2 Corinthians 13 and 5. Listen to what the God has to say unto the church.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Examine yourselves whether ye be in the faith.
Examine yourself. That's why you're doing it. That's what I said earlier. Examine yourself to see whether you're in the faith. Whether you're doing what God's telling you to do. Whether you're living the way God wants you to live.
Amen.
Whether you're talking the way God wants you to talk.
Yes.
And you ain't got to walk around saying Jesus, Jesus, Jesus all the time. But your conversation ought to be pure.
Amen.
And ought to be foul.
Amen.
You ought not be swaying halfway cursing and almost cursing. Whether you be in the faith. And then what it says?
Yes.
What it says? The other one after that.
Prove your own self.
Prove your own self. That's what you got to do. Look yourself. Look yourself over.
Amen.
And you know what prove means? To test.
Yes.
The truth in reality. Test it. Test yourself. Search yourself. That's proof. To test the truth, the validity, or the genuineness. Are you really genuine? Are you really a true servant of God? Come on now. Well, you know, I ain't what I used to be. But and I ain't what I ought to be. Or well, I ain't what I used to be. That's excuses. You got to be what God wants you to be. All y'all better come on with me now.
Amen.
It says to test the truth, validity, or genuineness of. To test the worth or quality of something. You got to prove. You got to prove to God that you ready.
All right.
To stand before God. You got to prove to God, amen, that you live it right.
Yes.
Saying that you live it right. Oh, I'm a Christian. I'm a Christian. Christians just saying you're a Christian don't make you a Christian.
That's right.
Christians live right.
Amen.
Christians are Christ-like.
Come on, say that now.
I'm going to say that again. Christians are Christ-like.
Amen.
I've never seen so many Christ-like folk, amen, in the towns.
All right.
Come on now, going to the racetrack.
Say it.
Playing bingo.
Come on.
Come on now. I ain't never seen so many Christians, amen, every now and then, amen, they cursing.
All right, say it.
All y'all can come on with
say
me now.
Say it, amen.
You need to examine yourself. right. And you know, sometimes people will tell you you ain't right. Sometimes people will tell you you ain't nothing. I heard one time when I was working, even this young man said, well, what about me? Because they were admiring him and the way I was living. And Thomas, he does this and this. He's a man of God. And the man, young man said, what about me? They said, you ain't nothing. People know sometimes you ain't living right.
Right. Yes, they do.
Amen. They can't even see your life.
Come on now.
Somebody ought to be able to see your life. You got to prove to other people that you're saved and sanctified. Not because you got a button on yourself that say I'm saved.
Right.
You got to live like you're saved.
That's right. That's right.
Well, y'all better come on with me now. What that Hebrews 9:27 said? Mm-hmm. Hebrews 9:27. Amen.
And as it is appointed unto men once to die, but after this, the judgment.
You hear what this writer said? And as it is appointed once, as it appointed unto men once to die, after that you will have to stand before God. And when you stand before God, what kind of excuse, God, I thought I was right. What you thought you had or what you thought you was, they going to get you to heaven. It's how you live it.
Amen.
Oh, somebody's going to be mad at me. But I'm just telling you the truth. I can say, look, you can be examining yourself now as I'm preaching.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
If you fit any of this category, amen, you ain't ready.
All right, man.
You're not ready for death. And if you don't die, Christ come back, you ain't ready for that either.
Come on.
Come on now. That's why I live holy every day. Sanctified. Oh, I know he got skeleton. You don't even know me.
Come on now.
But I thank God it ain't all about you. It's all about God.
Amen.
I care about what God said. I care about what God's Bible and the Word say. I care about what the Word say, even when amen. Don't you know that sometimes the Word will sometimes straighten saints out?
Come on.
Because sometimes they get off. Sometimes they get off, you know, not knowing that they're off. But God will put them back on the right road.
Yes, he will.
But they do it because they're seeking God. God, examine me. And then I will examine myself. Do you hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
There are factories, even car factories. Amen. Before they put some things out, they examine it.
Yes.
They examine it. Amen. They test it. They prove it. They try it. So when they put it out, they can say, we tried it. We had so many hours in doing this, so many hours in doing that, so many years of doing that. I know this is a perfect product. Can God say that about you?
All right.
When you know you have been tested and you've been tried and you went through every test and every trial, amen, without fussing and murmuring and complaining, amen, without fussing and almost about to cuss and almost about to run out on God, amen, you're proving to God, amen, that you're holy and you're sanctified.
Lord Jesus, yes, Lord.
It determines.
Holy.
Because you're going to be proven.
Glory to God.
You're going to be proven. In this world, you're going to be proven whether you're saved or not.
Hallelujah.
The devil's going to test you.
Come on.
God is sometimes going to allow the enemy to test you to see whether you say you got the good. You got the good. I'm going to stand. I got power, saints. You're going to be tested. You're going to be tried. Jesus was tried. He went through a lot of stuff just so that we could be saved.
Amen.
And the scripture tells us that we might follow, that we should follow in his footsteps.
Yes, amen.
He was our example.
Yes, he was.
He didn't fuss, he didn't cuss, you know, he didn't throw in the towel. Amen. Amen. He was a meek and humble lamb. What about us?
Amen, amen.
Come on now.
Amen.
Am I talking right?
Amen.
It has appointed unto me and wants to die. Why die before your time? Some of us can die before our time because we get out there and do things that we shouldn't do and it takes us out of here before our time.
All right.
We can do things against what the doctors told us to do and die before our time.
Come on now.
Let's go to somewhere else, Evangelist. Is that all right?
Yes.
Psalms 118:6a, the first part of the 100 of 6. We call it sometimes 8, 6a. Psalms 118:6, the first part of it.
Oh, give thanks unto the Lord.
That's Psalms 118.
And 6.
Yeah.
The Lord is on my side.
See, you gotta know God is on your side. See, this psalm is new that God was on his side. And what?
I will not fear what men do unto me.
Look, when you know the Lord is on your side, and you are living right, why should you fear? Not only what man may do to you, but what the devil is doing.
All right.
says, oh yeah, I'm not saying you shouldn't be apprehensive, you shouldn't be concerned, and you should not do what the people tell you to do to kind of protect yourself, but you should not be walking around with so much fear that you're so much scared to come out the door. Sometimes they got a law now where you have to stay inside. Okay, they trying to protect you, but still, knowing that you're saved, knowing that you examine yourself, you still won't obey the laws of the land. That's what you gotta do. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. If they telling you to do things that's contrary to the word of God, like sin, you don't have to obey that. Amen?
Amen.
But something that's gonna protect you, you gotta obey. I will not fear. Don't fear what men gonna do. Don't fear what they're gonna say or how they're gonna treat you. Amen. You got to live this thing for yourself. I'm on the Lord's side. And you got to know that you're on the Lord's side. And you're only on the Lord's side if you're living right.
Amen.
The Lord is on your side, amen, when you're living right. Because he's against those that commit sin.
Amen.
And
yes,
do evil.
Yes, he is.
Amen. The Bible says he's angry with the wicked every day.
Every day.
Every day. He's angry with the sinners. Every day. With the wicked. Every day. You know why? Because he sent his son to die for you that you might have life, and you won't even accept life.
Come on now.
You won't even accept Christ so you can have a better life. Come on now. The Lord is on my side.
Yes.
And I will not fear. We can say this when we know that we are living the way God wants us to live. We can say that. Ain't no sense of sticking your chest out when you know you're not living right.
All right.
That God is on your side. Come on now.
Amen.
The only way that God be on your side as a sinner is when you want to get saved.
Yes.
He on your side then. Come on up. Come on. Come on now. Come on.
Yes.
His arms are stretched out wide, ready to receive you.
Yes. Yes.
But you got to be willing to give it up. Amen. You got to be willing to give it up. You got to be willing to forsake sin.
Amen.
And you got to be willing to forsake those that sin around you. Don't mean that you can't be nice. You can't be, God bless you, how you doing, and shake hands and stuff like that. Amen. You can't mistreat people. Your disposition got to be changed.
That's right.
Different.
Amen.
Can we go to another one?
Yes.
Psalms 192. I'm sorry. Psalms 119. Mm-hmm. 52 through 60.
Okay. Amen.
I want you to follow me now. Psalms 119, 52 through 60. Write these scriptures down now.
I remember thy judgments of old, O Lord, and have comforted myself.
See, when you find yourself getting into a place where you're being tempted, you can remember the judgments of old.
Yes.
How God judged people in righteousness. And how God, amen, did towards them. And what? And have comforted myself.
Yes.
I know that God is a keeper.
Come on.
Because that what it was written for time, it was written for our learning. So when you, amen, was there for God's people, when he was there for his people, amen, that were living right, he protected them.
Yes, he did.
So I remember thy judgments of old, from way back, how you executed judgment, how you was there for us. I have comforted myself through that because I know that what God done before, he's the same God today, yesterday, and forevermore, and he changes not.
Come on.
Why would he change on you if you live it right?
Amen.
If you walk in right.
Yes.
Your mind ought to go back, huh?
Glory to God.
53.
Horror hath taken hold upon me because of the wickedness that forsake thy law.
Horror has taken hold upon me because of the wicked that forsake. He's looking at it. He's afraid. Horror has taken hold upon me because of the wicked that was. He got nervous because of the wicked.
Thy statutes have been my songs in the house of my pilgrims.
See, God's commandments, God's statutes, God's law, it's got to be like a song in your heart.
Yes.
In the house of my pilgrimage.
I have remembered thy name, O Lord.
I have remembered thy name. Amen.
In the night and have kept thy law.
Even in the night, in the dreary, sometimes when you see things like this, the coronavirus, that's like night.
Come on.
Darkness. Death is darkness. It's not light. Do you hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
That's a dark time in your life. And so, read that again.
I have remembered thy name, O Lord, in the night.
in the night, in the midnight hours, I have remembered thy name. Amen. When death was over me and shed, yes. It overshadowed me. I remember thy name. I remember the call on you. Help me, Jesus.
Yes. Amen.
In the night and have kept thy law. I didn't change.
Amen.
I didn't backslide. I didn't throw in the towel. I didn't give up. Ain't that much fear in the world for me to give up God because of things that's going on in this world. That's the time to really hold on to God. Uh-huh.
This I had because I kept thy precepts.
This I had because I kept thy laws. I have kept thy precepts. Uh-huh.
Yes. Thou art my portion, O Lord.
Can you say that? Thou art my portion, O Lord.
Uh-huh. I have said that I would keep thy word.
Are you keeping God's word? This ought to be your testimony.
Yes.
In the time of trouble.
Come on.
In the time of night.
Come
when
on.
It's dark. Can you fall back on this scripture?
Come on now.
Going down with my portion, O Lord. I have said that what?
I have said that I would keep thy word.
Uh-huh.
I entreated thy favor with my whole heart.
I want God to be pleased. Entreated thy favor with my whole heart. I want to be pleased
yes,
in you.
Yes, God. Yes, God.
I want to have favor in you.
Yes, God. Oh,
I entreated thy favor. With my whole heart, oh God, I want to be pleasing to you. I want to be walking up right before you.
Yes, Lord.
You know how I am. I want to be right.
Yes.
I want to be saved. I want to be whole. This is part one, y'all. I'm going to bring it again. What did it say?
Be merciful unto me according to thy word.
Be merciful, because God can't be merciful.
Yes, he can.
But then there has come a time that God will not have no mercy. Because the scripture says he'll have mercy on whom he will.
Yes, amen.
Do you hear what I'm saying? He's God. He can do that.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
I thought on my ways and turned my feet unto thy testimonies.
What did he say? I thought. He examined himself.
Yes, yes.
I thought on my ways. Are you thinking about what you're doing and how you're doing it? I follow my ways and turn my feet unto that testimony. So in other words, I thought about what I was doing, how I was doing it. Amen. And if he wasn't doing it right, he looked at God's laws.
Come on.
What did the law say? What did the word say? Yeah. I follow my ways and turn my feet unto that testimony.
Yes.
So he was preparing what he was doing to get the word of God.
Yes, yes.
What did he say?
I made haste. And delay not to keep thy commandments.
Look, he got in a hurry. That's what we got to do.
Yes.
When we find out we got in a place where we're supposed to be in God,
yes, God.
Amen, we got to make haste.
Yes, yes.
Don't put it off for tomorrow. Yes. You know what? I'll do it tomorrow. You know, I'll come up tomorrow. Yes. Now is the time. Now is the day.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
Why you want to continue to fall short every time? Fall short of what God wants you to do. I made haste. And delay not to keep his name. Oh God, if I'm not measuring up to this word here, God, I'm gonna make haste to do it.
Yes.
Because I know, amen.
Come on now.
That if I die tonight, if things happen to me tonight, amen, I'll be lost.
Yes.
Thinking that I'm all right with God. Oh, y'all gonna come on with me.
Amen.
And this was one of the scriptures I wanted to use so by examining yourself.
Yes.
I thought on my ways. Some people don't even want to think about that.
Right.
You know, do you really realize what you're doing? I don't care. That's that I don't care attitude.
Mm-hmm.
I do what I do. Say what I want to say. And if they don't like it, forgive them. Because
right.
You know I ain't got to give an account to them. No, you got to give an account to God.
Amen.
Everybody got to stand before what? The judgment seat of God.
Amen.
To give an account. Is that all right?
Amen.
I said this, but I'm going to read it again. I'm going to read it. Psalms 116 and 15. This is something that gives saints hope.
Yes.
And I'm still not saying, you know, you might want to die, but you have this attitude and knowing, and it comforts you, even when you're on your sick bed.
Man.
That God, that the psalmist was saying this, giving you confidence. What did it say?
Precious in the sight of the Lord
is what?
Is the death of his saints.
Precious. valuable.
Yes.
Honorable.
Come on.
In the sight of the Lord is the death.
Amen.
Of his what?
Saints.
Saints. Not saints that ain't, but saints. That's what you want. That's what you want to fulfill there, right there. Knowing that you're a precious jewel to God.
Yes. Amen. Amen.
Can we go to another?
Glory to God. Amen.
Proverbs.
Yes.
Y'all bear along with me.
Come on.
Proverbs 1, 22 through 30. I want you to follow me now.
Amen.
This is a question, one of the questions I got to ask you.
Come on.
Well, some people are simple-minded.
Yes.
I beg your pardon. Well, that's the Bible said.
That's what the Word says.
That's what the Word says. I want to read what's coming from the Word. What does Solomon say?
How long, ye simple ones?
How long, ye simple ones?
Will ye love simplicity?
When you want it to be easy, simple. How long will you love? You simple ones want to love. You want the easy way. You want the easy way of living when it comes down to living holy and sanctified. You want the easy way. You know, you don't want to give up this. You don't want to give up that. You want to continue to do that and still have God. But how long, you simple ones, will you love simplicity? Because in this life, you're going to have some difficulties.
And the scorners delight in their scorning, and fools hate knowledge.
Fools hate knowledge. Don't you, word, don't you know the Word will give you knowledge? Word has, this God's Word's got wisdom in it, and it'll show you.
Turn you at my reproof. Behold, I will pour out my spirit unto you. I will make known my words unto you.
See, this is when you examine yourself. Turn you at my reproof, because he will reprove you. Behold, I will pour out my spirit unto you, and I will make known my word. You don't have to go to hell.
Come on.
You don't have to be lost. He'll make known his words to you.
Yes.
He'll make known to his law to you.
Amen.
He don't want you to go to hell. He don't want you to be lost.
Yes.
But sometimes people want the simple way. The easy way.
Amen.
And we know that on this road it's not going to always be easy. When we're going to grow up and mature in God. Because we want to be in the place that God wants us to be.
Amen.
Because I have called and he refused.
Because I called. He's calling now. He's calling now.
Come on.
Some of y'all refusing it now.
See?
Some of you aren't accepting it now.
Come on.
Behold, what it said, because I have called.
And you refuse.
Uh-huh.
I have stretched out my hand, and no man regarded.
Uh-huh.
But ye have said it not, all my counsel.
Uh-huh.
And were none of my reproof.
You wouldn't even take my correction.
Glory to God.
Because I have called and ye refused. I have stretched out my hand and no man regarded it.
Come on.
But he, what?
But ye have set at naught all my counsel.
Oh, it don't mean nothing to you. You ain't doing it. I ain't doing it.
Yes.
It doesn't have any effect on me.
Yes.
And with none of my reproof. I also will laugh at your calamity.
Look at that. On your time come. See, that's what they're doing now.
Yeah.
See, they scared. They scared because calamity is here. They scared of coronavirus because the calamity is here. And they're afraid.
Come on.
I still say nothing wrong with being afraid. But what you going to do when it's over?
Come on.
But God said, what did he say in that 26th verse?
I also will laugh at your calamity. I will mock when your fear comes.
See, when it grabs hold to you. You didn't want him. You didn't want him when I was trying to get you ready for some of these things that's going to go on. And I had prophesied that it was going to happen. There was going to be pestilence.
Come on.
You didn't regard that. You didn't take it to hope. You didn't take that in mind. But now you see that it hit and knocked on your door. You won't die. But it said, I also will laugh at your calamity and I will mock you. I will mock when your fear comes. Now you're scared. Yeah, God will laugh at you. And he will mock you. When you say, oh Lord, he'll say, oh Lord. Because he tried to reach out to you, just like he's trying to reach out to you now.
When your fear cometh as desolation.
Go ahead.
And your destruction. destruction cometh as a whirlwind. When distress and anguish cometh upon you.
Look at that. Then that's when they want to run to God.
Then shall they call upon me.
Then. They're doing that.
Holy glory.
They're doing it now. Even government calling on God. Oh, y'all know I'm right. Let's get together and let's pray. Ain't nothing wrong with praying, but what you gonna do after it's all over?
Come on now.
You still gonna be fighting among yourselves. You still gonna be, amen, doing misusing folks among yourselves. Come on now. Where's the peace among yourselves?
All right, come on.
When your fear cometh as desolation and your destruction cometh as the whirlwind. Look at it. Y'all can see, it's got people set on edge. When distress and anguish come upon you, then shall they call. See, that was written years ago. Then shall they call upon God. But he said what?
But I will not answer.
Mm-hmm.
They shall seek me early, but they shall not find me.
Oh, let's pray, y'all. Let's pray. Let's pray. Let's get on our knees.
Yes.
Church houses full of them. Come on over here. Let's pray. Well, what was you doing before this thing happened? What was you doing from all these other diseases was happening? Like I said, people ran to the church, and as soon as they found out they were in safety, they went back to their pernicious ways. You see the way your heart was? It wasn't really about pleasing God. You was worried about God, amen, getting rid of that pestilence. But he said, but I will not answer. They shall seek me early, but shall not find me. For they, go ahead, 29.
For that they hated knowledge and did not choose the fear of the Lord.
So when I was trying to get you ready, when I was trying to tell you about these pestilence and things that was going to happen, and trying to tell you about yourself, and that you ain't going to live forever, you didn't want to hear it.
Amen.
You hate it now. Nobody want to hear that stuff. Some people saying that now. Nobody want to hear that stuff. You better want to hear.
Come on.
It's too late when you go to hell to want to hear. What did the preacher say? It's too late. Don't let it be said. Too late to hear that. What? The golden gate. You don't want it to be said like that. For that they hated knowledge and did not choose the fear of the Lord to reverence God.
Amen.
What they're fearing is destruction, more than they're fearing God.
They would not of my counsel. They despise all my reproach.
They despise. Don't you know some people just hate when Christian people get up and preach and teach the word of God? We don't want to hear that mess. But they only want to hear things that's going to satisfy the flesh. You can make it. You can go through. Got people shouting and dancing, and still they're telling them what they need to do, that they need to examine themselves and see how they be in the faith. That's what they need to do.
Amen.
Oh, gracious Father, we thank you today. We thank you for the word of God. We know that the word of God goes out and accomplishes what it will, and it will not return to void. We thank you, O God, for the word that you have put in our mouth and in our spirit, O God, to warn those, amen, that are fearful, O God. And we understand the fear, O God. But still in that fear, they ought to want to examine themselves and see that if this thing get a hold of them, where will they spend eternity?
Yes, Lord.
Oh, God, right now, O God, touch somebody's heart, touch somebody's mind, that they might turn, O God, from their wicked way.
Yes.
And those that think that they're saved, think they're living right, O God, that they might search themselves, examine themselves, and scrutinize themselves, amen, thoroughly, amen, so that they might know, God, because they can't have not one spot, blemish, wrinkle, or any such thing in this life, O God, in order to make it. Right now, God, we ask for you to touch the hearts of men everywhere, oh God. Let your mercy reign, oh those, oh God, that you have mercy, oh God, in the name of Jesus, oh God. We know that you're able to do exceed above those things that we even think or ask according to the power that is within you, oh God, right now, oh God. Even protect your saints, even the Lord, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Have mercy even on the cell, oh God, because you would that no man when?
Thank you, Jesus.
Was the last
glory,
time?
Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah.
Vengeance. When was the last time?
Amen.
When?
Thank you, Jesus.
Think about it. Christian people.
Yes.
Church folks. When was the last time?
Yes.
That you examined yourself.
Come on, come on.
God bless you.
God bless you. Amen.
Pray for me.
Amen, amen.
As I pray for you.
Yes.
God bless you.
Amen.